Hello and good morning, welcome to another little video guide of me. My name is TLS Shariyama. I'm playing World vs. World for about 2 years now. I got a subscriber that just asked for a video about squad compositions in World vs. World, for how can you be the most efficient and what is the reason for it. So I will give you a little overview about what you can do in World vs. World and what the commander and the blobs should look at. I hope you enjoy, and like always, thank you for your support on your videos and on my stream, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Have a good time. So what most of people know most likely is that commanders are leading on Firebrand most of the time, let's say 99% of the time. There are several reasons. From you can control the melee lane, you can control the cooldowns, you can call out some cooldowns for the melee stuff, you can stun break, cleanse, heal yourself, and you're also a tank, so it makes it a lot easier for you to stay alive and to give coordinated stuff away from you. Like, you have to multitask a lot as a commander while you have to play the game, you have to look at your parties, you have to give commands and everything, so it also makes it easier for you to do that kind of stuff. It's a full minstrel guardian at that point. I will also link something under the video after this guides, so people can watch some of the pictures. Every party should end up with a maximum of two of the same classes. For example, two scourges, not three, would be the best at the end. So what is the best composition? In my opinion, and in a lot of other opinions, the basic setup for a party in World vs. World is normally a Firebrand. A Firebrand with full minstrel gear as a full support frontline tank healer, together with main source of stability and a lot of other boons giving out, so you can support your squad as a main support in the party. Party is always 5 people, so you have to support these 5 people over the squad, and your party will be fine if you are doing a good job. As a second class, normally you're adding a Revenant. By adding a Revenant in your party, what you can do is you add AoE damage with the facets, you add spike damage with the hammer. So basically your party, for example, when it goes down, can be rallied. You also deal some damage, so they all get kill participation, and. Also, the Revenant is providing a lot of offensive boons that can help your squad a lot by, for example, pulsing fury, pulsing swiftness, giving super speed on a push that you need. All that kind of stuff can help the party, so basically you are a main power source in terms of damage, but at the same time you're supporting the party on varieties of that way, so you can go as a second support, basically as an offensive one. The third class should be a necro. You can go up to 2 necros, or even when there is like more people, you can get even more. Necros have the main thing to do is barriering for the party. They can also strip the enemies, so their main corrupt is also really, really good and hopefully used good by them. At the same time, they have a lot of AoE damage, CC, and they provide also kill potential for the party, so the party, the healer and the boon giver also get some if they boon them and if they help them, what they are getting is kill participation, and they also get their XP. The Scourge is very reliant on a good supporter, so be sure you have a stability source and a healing source, and maybe a Revenant for pulsing fury for more damage in the party. So as you can see there, as well the Revenant as also the Scourge as offensive classes can support the squad with their offensive sources really well. Furthermore, like after these 3 classes, it gets a bit more different. Normally you want the second support in a party. You can either go for a second Firebrand in that term, and this Firebrand can also go instead of legendary lores on Firebrand trait, then maybe for Stalwart speed if you know what you're doing, for example. Or you're going for a Tempest. Tempest is strong in terms of immobilizing, in cleansing and AoE heals, you can ban blasting, so Tempest can be very useful in that turn. Or you're going for a Scrapper. A Scrapper is a class that can also cleanse a lot, heal a lot, provide blasting, provide some CC and helping the party to stay alive at that turn. A very good class for the squad. I recommend to have at least like 8 to 10 in a squad when you have a really good squad composition. So basically you have now two supports in your squad. What can you help out with staying alive? Now it comes to the special classes in my terms. So you can go for the last spots either for a warrior. A warrior is there to strip boons, you can hunt some people that are not staying on tag, you can provide melee push pressure, and you can deal a lot of damage as a warrior, and the main source of you in the squad and in blob fights are bubble, for example, break enchantment, that kind of stuff. So the better you're getting with your bubble up, with for example defense stance and defiance stance or more other stuff, the better you are for the squad. There is also a berserker build, but it's not that reliant for the squad since you're not helping the squad in any terms on that way. You can also take some stuff like shake it off or something to cleanse yourself, and you can also go for some skills to just support the squad at the end. There are several ways to support the squad as a spellbreaker too if you want, but it's not needed. At the end you also can deal damage, and it's good if you, for example, get a really good bubble off. So I hope there is some other videos that can tell you how to get the bubble off perfectly, and then you will be very useful for your squad. The second class that you can take in is a mesmer. Mesmers at the moment are divorced between Mirage, Core Mesmers and about Chronomancer. People play it as support, as a damage, as a condi or whatever. What the squad needs from them is utility support. You can speed people up, you can help with boons, you can help with healing if you're taking it, you can provide CC if you want, you can provide burst damage if you want, but you can also provide invisibility and portals that can help the commander for pushing, that can help the commander for surprising people. And you can, for example, if you play Chronomancer, also go for Gravity Well as a huge CC. So it's a utility support for your squad. If no one of that classes is there, or you don't have a range tag, or you don't have enough people, one of the last classes you can also fill in the squad. Best would be with a Revenant in the party to provide Fury. It's an Elementalist. Elementalist as Weaver, as a damage class, is a very high DPS class in terms of glass cannon. So you need to learn to position yourself well, and you need a good guardian to support you, or a good squad to keep a look at you, and you need a commander that knows how to pull the enemies through the meteor showers if they are placed not that good, that you guys deal a lot of damage. So the Weaver is one of the last guys that can be in the squad to support at the end, and then you have your party full. So you can go, for example, as a squad composition for Firebrand, for Revenant, for Scourge, for Scrapper, and for example for Weaver, Tempest, Mesmer or Warrior, and then you have a good composition. You should not go for any Rangers, for Thieves, for Reapers, for Dragon Hunters, for Core Revenants. There is also several other classes that are not that good in big scale. They are better in small scales, so you guys should play a class that is in the current meta. The meta is for a reason, since all the classes synergize with each other really well, and you guys wanna support the commander and win some fights. So I suggest to go for one of those classes to help your server, to help the blob for fighting, and to make the commanders happy, since they are always flaming and kicking people who are not playing on proper classes. And if you look on the servers that are being the best at the moment, you will not see troll classes in the squad. You will see them around sniping some people, but you will not see them in the squad if they play properly. In short terms, I will just read what I wrote down for you. There aren't more than 5 players within the same party. The reason is simple. The vast majority of every skill, boon, condition, etc. in the game affects a maximum of 5 targets. There aren't more than 2 classes of the same specialization in a soul party. There is a main source of stability in all parties. There is also a main boon support and cleave in all parties. There is a main source of barrier support and corrupts. There is a second healing support in the majority of parties. There is a filler class that can be raw damage dealer or support. What I wanna clarify for you guys is, a class can be considered support even if it doesn't bring heals. For instance, Herald brings support through its boon output and Mirage with its CC. That was my little guide about World vs. World squad composition. I hope that you liked it. If I forgot something, you guys can add that towards under my video. Leave a comment. Be sure to subscribe to the channel to get new videos. And if you have an idea about a video guide or something, join my Discord. Send me a mail about it. If it is a custom video about something, don't be shy to subscribe or follow on my channel and ask for any videos I like to make and any guides. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope I could help some people out. I know it's more a beginner guide, but let's see if we can get the meta going in World vs. World again. So I wish you a great day and thank you for watching.